Subaya didi. Manandure. Ah, guys. Nanda kurara wanu wangu request. Mkuma yuda zokai. Nai, 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 guys. Wani janda nda oneka. Ndika dijama uya, ma uya, ma uya komredi. Mauya mujadzukira. Mauya mauya komredi. Mauya mujadzukira. Mauya mauya komredi. Mauya. I'm not going to take long. Clinton, should I say? Omuga ndamutswa nevanhu hanzi zoka 2 minutes ndandatorara inini ndandatorara guys but ndamutswa hanzi zoka 2 minutes hanzi tiri kunzwa nyaya yekuti masoja emuZimbabwe ari kuda kustrike saka zviri kufamba sei ndikati alright I've got hanzi sorry time here. Story time. About a story time. It's the strike of Masoja. Andrew Vunzwan. One phone yangu. Yes, runs Masoja at him so 27. 27 February. Zimbabwe soldiers have decided to take it to the streets to demand a living wage. People are asking me whether this is true. We need to hear old stories. I really like them. Thanks, Chimbago. Thank you. We will talk old stories as well. Saganas. I've made a presentation, a long presentation, and I've just finished that presentation. Then someone had to ring me and say, can you go live, please, Shepherd? Guys, the problem is, I'm going to say my stars are actually. I'm going to tell you the internet actually, but let me just say, I agree with you. Let me just say, my old stories, okay, we'll incorporate things as we go on. There is a Twitter message that has been sent by the Zimbabwe National Army handle that on the 27th of February they are going into the streets. The soldiers have decided that no, enough is enough. They are going into the streets. They are trying to earn a living wage. They want a living wage. I said to the people last time, look at Emerson Mnangagwa. I want to show you guys. I want to show you. Can you see? This is not a Photoshop. This picture is not a Photoshop. This is the president of Zimbabwe. The president of Zimbabwe. This is the president of Zimbabwe, Comrade Emerson Dambudzo Mnangagwa. Let's see. This is the president of Zimbabwe. These are his close security. This one, that one, and that one. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Right, so far I've counted 20 close security aides with red tires and white shirts. They are not the only ones here. Then you look at these with blue tires. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. 12. 32. members of the close security for the president. I've counted 32 people who are surrounding one person, protecting one person. Right, not only them, there are also these yellow barrets, this presidential guard, 1, 2, 3, 4. This one armed. This is the periphery. The presidential guard is the periphery. They form the periphery. It's a brigade on its own. Probably it has got 60 people, 60 soldiers, fully armed. One of my RPK with them. One of my AKs. One of my Zagawanda man. One of my pistols around them. One different one, my pistols, my AKs, my Uzi, my RPK, different rifles. Zawanigwana surrounding one man. So when Emerson is traveling, wherever he's traveling, probably you'll be having about 1,000 people surrounding him. Secured, all of them paid by you. They're all paid by you, taxpayers. He has gone to the extent, the Zimbabwe president has gone to the extent of scared. He is so scared. I don't know why is he scared. He's very scared. He is very, very scared. He is the only president in Southern Africa who is protected in this way. There is no other president in SADC who is protected as Emmerson Mnangagwa. He is very scared. He is very, very scared. Nobody knows. Everywhere he goes with over 1,000 security men around him. He knows exactly that he's doing something wrong. Because if you were the president of a country, you were voted by these people, definitely there is nowhere, everywhere you go, you take about 1,000 people to guard you. We have got an issue about Kabila. Remember, Laurent Kabila. Abanaskazwe Laurent Kabila. Who took over from Mobutu Sese Seko? Laurent Kabila probably had a similar security to Emmerson Mnangagwa. You remember that Laurent Kabila, who waged a war against Mobutu Sese Seko. Kabila became president from 1997, and he died in 2001. He was assassinated. Laurent Desire Kabila, Desire Kabila. Everybody still remember the issue of Laurent Desire Kabila. He was a Congolese, a rebel leader who led the rebels to attack DRC. By then it was called Zaire. I'm well, Karin, how are you? How are you? My mom is here as well. Anga Tazakwesked and Aga Safura Mugabe and G Ford Ugu Aga Bambu Zimwana. Zimbos are against him. yes, Bambi Chance. How are you? Zuru Fambe, long time, Bambu Mingong, long time. Sarawaso, Manoma. But anyway, welcome with that vision. I like it. But Anzi, Mdaro, Angatanzi Kuchka. Anzi, one. Agarwambu Zimwana. Yeah, remember when I was telling you last time when I was doing a live on Facebook, I was talking about Mbuzi Mwana. There was a prisoner at Harare Remand Prison. This guy was arrested. Then he wanted bail, the wife to pay bail. So when the wife came, siyai mari, kana anambava, mugaru wa mari zenyu, siyai mari ku Zimbabwe kuitira mangwana kana vakadzi venyu vakuda kubhadharira mabhero. This guy ana kusiya mari. Mukadzi wake akauya ku remand, ndobva akumuti zvikanzi iwe. And I put a bill, but then I think it was $2,000. It was a lot of money by then. And I put a bill on high court. But I put a bill, she can say, I think in Okwana. Oh, God, I name where I always zero and on Badar Rabel. Sakamka Zagasham Sigal Marari, Abailo Jonah Nifields, Kirby, Anna Dangarim Boots. Mukadzi akashamisika kati, kosara. Mbudzi yakutaurwa pana baba vakuda kundotengesa mbudzi, ndodziwana kupi mbudzi dzacho, inini ndirojawo zvangu muno muHarare. Saka mbudzi dzikunzi nababa ndonotengesa, ndodziwana kupi. So you find kuti murume manje mukadzi akashamisika kuti, what do you mean? Murume akunongedzera, inotengesa mbudzi. And I take some boots, man. Don't take some boots. Take some boots. Money, beer, and no corner. Some guys are buzz out all right. Baba run to Molu in the Chihuri. Because no binder, one over my egg, no back one, no badder, and face beer. Saga, Drutar is a president with Zimbabwe. Apana is the most scared person in Zimbabwe. There is no any other scared person like him. He goes around a very close security, the inner core, your president. It has got 20 individuals armed with pistols and everything. To my briefcase, I'm not going to put us. I'm not going to put us. My father said, I take some booze, dear. I'm not going to. So you find good. Muka, one of the presidents in SADC who was so scared, like Emmerson Mnangagwa, he was Laurent Kabila, who came to power in 1997, and he died in 2001. Laurent Kabila was assassinated. The people who assassinated him in 2001 were the people who assisted him to be president. At the QD, how are you? How are you? How are you? Welcome to the program. I had gone to bed and someone had to ring me and say, look, we don't understand, Shepard. We have seen a message that is saying Zimbabwe National Army, they are taking to the streets to demonstrate or to strike about a living wage on the 27th of February 2023. So people wanted to know if I've got any information regarding this intended strike. To be honest with you, nothing officially has been communicated to me about this strike. But what I understand is Zimbabwean soldiers are being paid nuts. Havana Maria Varkura. Saga Swasina Maria Varkura. One way kuti you cannot rule out could they want to demonstrate or they want to strike or they want to get into the road and do what they did to Robert Gabriel Mugabe. You never know. Mobutu. Saka, you never know, guys. That might be the case. Soldiers might want to demonstrate, but Some are saying the constitution of the country does not allow soldiers to demonstrate. And I don't know why certain ZANU-PF individuals are bringing the issue of constitution now. When they removed Mugabe, they never brought issue of constitution. What does the constitution say on the sitting president? And when they killed innocent people, they don't bring the constitution into play, because the constitution of Zimbabwe does not allow anyone to kill anyone. If you kill someone, you need to be arrested, you need to be sent to court. From court, if you are convicted, you can be sentenced to death, and you die by hanging. This is what the constitution of the country says. There is no one above that law. So we have seen a lot of ZANU-PF people committing murder. They have never been arrested. They are walking scot-free right now. Certain people are not sure about what to do with those people, those murderers walking scot-free in our country. Let me assure you guys, if you are a clever person, don't be used by politicians to commit heinous crimes like murder. Stay away from those crimes, because murder is never pardonable. I want to warn those ZANU-PF people who kill people because they belong to ZANU-PF, and they kill, and their victims are perceived opposition members. And you go to their houses, you burn their houses, you beat them up, and you kill them. Murder is never pardonable anywhere in the world. If you commit murder in Harare and you flee to Mozambique, like what Muvevi wanted to do, the long hands of the law will catch up with you. If you flee murder and go to any country around the world, there is what we call Interpol. They can assist your apprehension and repatriation back to face justice. This is why you see today all those people who committed genocide in Rwanda and fled, they are being sought. All those people in Uganda who committed genocide are being sought. And all those people in Zimbabwe who are committing these heinous crimes, killing people, and think you are immune to prosecution, be warned. If a new government comes in today, you are going to be charged of murder. You are going to be charged of murder. You'll be arrested. So don't be used by ZANU-PF to say, I'm going to come, Mr. So-and-so, we are having elections, and these people, they don't want to vote for us, so please go beat them up and kill them. Once you kill, definitely you should know that you are not going to be spared. In the event, and things are going to change in Zimbabwe. ZANU-PF is going to lose power. It might take 100 years, but ZANU-PF will eventually lose. There is no political party that will run that nation for the rest of its, for the entire life, for its span of life. So be warned that you are going to be prosecuted. You have committed murder, no doubt, and the people are aware. The likes of Chonza Anichimfana, Yeshon's Godfrey Gomoya, that one is a potential prisoner, a D-class on death row. I assure you, Godfrey Gomoya, if there is change of government today, you'll be in prison, and he's gonna be hanged. Daita Urainini, that this death row or death sentence, it must not be suddenly removed because there is change of government in our country. No, no, no. you must keep a death sentence for about 5 years or so, and make sure you clear those people who committed murder. They must face justice. They must go to court. The judges must try them fairly. If they are convicted, please take them to the gallows. Then we will allow the president to sign their death warrants so that they can feel it. Because here is to make them feel. It's not kudzorera zvavakaita, no. But it's to meet justice. Itai Dzamara, obvious, he was killed. By now we are assured that he is not kept anywhere by ZANU-PF government, but they have killed him. And the people who killed Itai Dzamara are known. It's a matter of time that the people who took him, who came to arrest him, who said you are under arrest are known, and they know where they take Itai Dzamara to. So those people, it's a matter of time. They are going to be apprehended. And no matter if you are the boss in the army, if you are the boss in the CIO, no matter wherever, no matter the rank that you hold, you need to face justice. So wherever you are, you really know that you did this. You committed this crime. Crime of murder is a crime in our country that receives capital punishment. And the capital punishment means death sentence. So you are going to face justice. We don't mince our words. And we are firm, fair. You know, it's T-next E-T, just as firm and fair. We can end up at the bench prison, T-next E-T, just as, which means firm and fair. The law must be firm and fair. Anyone who committed murder in the name of ZANU-PF, in the name of the robbery, in the name of, in any form, committing murder with no extenuating circumstances. Because if you go and kill for political reasons, there are no extenuating circumstances whatsoever. You have planned it and you went on to execute your plans. So you deliberately killed someone, fully aware that you are killing someone for political gains, for financial gains, for whatever reasons that you want to gain something. So be warned, ZANU-PF is not going to rule the country forever. And you are a candidate for being a D-class, when a B-O, when a gallows, you are worse than Chidumo. People were listening when I was talking about Chidumo. Ukaona uchiuraya munhu politically for political reasons, you are worse than Chidumo. Both Chidumo, vana Chidumo vaienda nana Masendeke vachiterrorize vanhu kuma praise, vachiterrorize vanhu kuma store, vachibira vanhu. What they were gaining there was probably money and the property they were taking away from their victims. So when we come to you as a perpetrator of political violence, which result in killings of innocent people, what you are benefiting, obvious, when you kill someone for ZANU-PF, ZANU-PF will pay you. That means you have robbed someone's lives and someone is paying you for robbing that person's life. That means you are a candidate. You are worse than Chidumo. But Chidumo ayango shika nepfuti panapa oridza pfuti otora mari otora chi kana dzongwai pfura chiuraya otiza oenda. Wangofanana na Chidumo kana uri worse than Chidumo. Unoenda pamba pemunhu unomutora kuti uri kusupportire triple C. Moenda mono basha munhu ye mumbaya baya nemapanga kana kumtema nematemo. Mumuraya. Saka be assured that the law will take its course. You will be arraigned before the courts. You will be charged with murder. It's not simple enjoy life in you. Kana muri vamwana makauraya endai kuzanu pia kumupiwe futi more money dzekuti murambe makadhakwa. Ndadzoka mukoma zawe. ndadzorwa nevanhu pane vanhu vanifonera vakati there is an issue iri kutaurwa kunzi masoja varoda kustrike varoda kustrike masoja ipapo ndakachitarisa security yamunangagwa I've counted about 32 people who are in the close security Emerson every time paanofamba zviri kuratidza kuti ane kakutya kaanako ane kakutya is not a free man he has got too much fear and his fear emanates from what I'm talking about the killing of innocent civilians and the thinking of kuti vanhu vandakaurayira hama dzavo vaivai vanogona kuda kudzosera anytime vanodagona kudzosera Ndevele people are not happy about Emerson Mnangagwa. Remember, I spoke about that is Saul Nwe, the MP for Matobo South. Pane audio that leaked, I should have heard. Tuto shy away, Mnangagwa to Murase, because of the Gugura Wound issue. So he is, to him, Mnangagwa is not a safe man, even when traveling in that country. This is why he takes a brigade every time he goes away because he is scared. Munhu anorara 24 hours achizot panza pakakomberedzwa nepfuti. Because that hope adzuye kana uchingorara uchifunga kuti anytime dzogona urira panza. Vanhu vakakomba, I don't trust them. Vanhu vakandikomba vanogona kuatakwa. Ndichivingwa inini ndichida kuurawa. Andiriona. Saka upenyu hwake hwese anangaita kuti ari patambo. Andiona. Ndosaka achifamba nebrigade achirara akagadwa achifamba akagadwa auite mweya auite mweya bozo kaita mweya vanhu vanotoziva kuti waita mweya andiriona aufeme plus futi yambotaura namukoma chandai yekuti kutsotsa mbuzi dzevana it's another crime saka ukaona une security yakadaro uri president wenyika you are just like Laurent Kabila we all know about Laurent Kabila, who came to power through a civil war in DRC Congo in 1997. On the 16th of January 2001, he was assassinated by the same people who assisted him to be president of DRC Congo. Atete Monica Zirise. He became president in 1997. He was assassinated in 2001 in January by the same people who assisted him to become president of DRC. He had taken power from Mobutu Sese Seko. Mobutu Sese Seko came to power in 1965. DRC, I think he was the first, if not second, president of DRC. He was going on Lumumba and so forth. But he became president of Zaire in 1965 and he was removed in 1997 through a civil war. And the person who took over was known as Desire Laurent Kabila, who was assassinated in 2001, in January 2001. Nobaka Sopinda, his adopted son, Jose Kabila. So, if you look at what happened in DRC, after Mobutu was removed, Mobutu died in 1997. He died the same year he was removed. He died in Morocco. I still remember when we were talking about, when I went to DRC to Congo in Kivu, we were talking about Mobutu Sese Seko with certain local people. When they spoke about Kabila, when they spoke about this guy, Mobutu, who later died in Morocco. And we don't know how he ended up in Morocco. He was probably the richest African in DRC, Mobutu. He was the richest president in Africa. But he left all those monies and he died in exile. So I'm looking at a situation where Emerson Mnangagwa came to power in 2017 through a coup. He marched the soldiers, he deployed the soldiers with the assistance of the army general during that time. They never spoke about the constitution of a country, that the constitution does not allow that. But these guys, they proceeded deploying soldiers into Harare, Harare streets, blocking all the way into Harare. They disarmed all other battalions. Police was disarmed, and CIOs were disarmed. As a result, Mnangagwa did a coup and came in as president. When he came in as president, he went to White City Stadium in Bulawayo for a rally where grenades were thrown at him. And those grenades, White City bombing, that what we call White City bombing, in Bulawayo, grenades flew, and there was an explosion where two people were killed in that explosion. Ndopatakaona vanhu vaiva maifungidzira kuti mavo veterans masoja vanhu vakarwa hondo ana Kembo Muhadi. Ndakaona Kembo Muhadi anamirana nekamukamukadzi so apa aakuzviwetera, ndopakakukwara vana Mary Chiwenga and so forth. Vanhu vataifungidzira kuti vanoziva zvekuita, because if you hear that sound what you need to do is you duck down. Grenade rinobuda anonzi mashrapnels. Munenge mune maspikiri, mune tumwe tumabhora turimo twakatango kupakwa impactly. Saka tukabasta ino tuedo tunorova pasi tuchiti mwaa kusimuka kudai. Saka your chances of being hit kana wakamira, they are high. So you can quickly duck down if something of that happened. Both tosimuka tuchisimuka tuchimwaya kudai somudenga. Saka you see that on 23 June 2018, a grenade was thrown at Emmerson Mnangagwa and his entourage. And that blast, it was at a campaign rally. Pakakandwa magrenades iwayo. Zvakaita kuti Mnangagwa akasiri kumhanya. It was a planned thing. Some people say it was planned, and that grenade aimed to eliminate Constantino Chiwenga, because Chiwenga was the mastermind of the coup, and being the mastermind of the coup, being alive, obvious, he was gonna plot again. Because once you take a country by coup, expect to be removed by coup. This is what happens in any coup government anywhere in the world. You do your coup today, tomorrow you are removed by coup. And the same people like Constantino Chiwenga, who masterminded the coup, are gonna be the same people who mastermind the downfall of Emmerson Mnangagwa. So Mnangagwa, people think Mnangagwa knew exactly what he wanted. First, he wanted to eliminate Chiwenga. And how to eliminate Chiwenga? This is why you see Mnangagwa pakango pedza speech yake akabuda with the anambomira zvomhoresa vanhu zvezvo, angobuda achimhanya to give gap rekuti pakandwe grenade. And that grenade rakakandwa, unfortunately Chiwenga anenge akabackpedlere, but ndo luck rakaita, plus akaprotectwa ne the other people who were around him vakarohwa negrenade iro riya. Otherwise taura kwatirikuita akadai akatsatsaurwa, it was like a plotted assassination where they wanted to eliminate Chiwenga. But mukanya nenyaya yekuti chikoro chishoma and hadzinyanyo rizina maningi, he doesn't see how bad things are around him. Those soldiers who helped him, the generals who helped him, all of them are now gone. Ndifunga asara kana asara iye anenge asara iye now about 2 or 3, but the rest are gone. Vana SB mumwe yekuya achiverenga kuti things are at a certain stage, he's no more, he's gone. Vana nzanani vaivai, vana Chimonyo, vanani vakawanda. All the generals who made sure the coup is successful are all gone. Vana Zimonda havasipo, vana Perens Shiri vakarova pasi, vakawanda. Recently vakaviga mumwe. Saka that means those powerful generals who could influence kuti amunanga gwa rutadzo let's remove him tisem soldier are all gone vasara vakutya kuti akangosimudza musoro warova pasi saka it's like general now abisirwa his generals around him kuti he hasina any power hasina any sense ndosaka ongora ngoti hakuna anovabvisa shumba azvireudi hakuna anovabvisa but akutya manje akuona kuti alright ndofungana dzikarara hopadziuye kuti alright parents arova pasi SB akarova pasi all the guys vanakabva vekuarmy vandakashanda navo tichigadzira this chinhu chechinhu ichi havasipo why is it on the other side kumasivirian havasi kufa vanachinamasa varipo havasi kufa the rest vavanhu vaed hapana ari kufa kurungofa vanhu vekamaflash chete yakatanga ichinzi covid and you wonder kuti covid inouya muzimbabwe yongoro vanhu vakapfeka inform chete atimona so you find that during that bombing in White City about 49 people were injured and there were two dead pakafa two one mumwepanhu akafa ipo was a member of the presidential guard akarohwa akarohwa mashrapnels they landed in his brains and he died and more saka if we look at all that that could be the reason why Emerson Mnangagwa surround himself now with a battalion because he doesn't trust anyone mistake yakaita was to dismantle the CIO actually they were pro Mugabe this is why I always tell people that President Chamisa kana machindinzwa right now as I'm talking we know this year it's gore rako mudhara you are going to be president of that country if you want to be a successful president make sure that those people vanoita gather intelligence yenyika do not work for you personally they work for the country they protect the country one that will stamp out corruption hakuna minister anoita corruption kana pane an intelligence agents inoshandira nyika ukangoita corruption yako uri minister wabatwa dai CIO yakagarira intelligence yenyika kutaura kwatuita nyika yezimbabwe yakanaka bose aive nevanhu vanonzi veintelligence saka if you look at it now togona ngoti vanhu veintelligence but why zimbabwe isina road why madiamonds 15 billion yakabiwa why tichinzi kuchipatara hakusina mishonga why tichinzi sakunda anongopuwa every tender yaiswa yese inongoenda kuna sakunda andona because we lack intelligence hatina vanhu veintelligence ukaenda kuamerica unoona kuti vanonzi macia unoona kuti vanonzi mafbi unoona vakawanda maintelligence organizations eikoko each and every department ine intelligence yayo kune vanotoona kuti CIA inoshanda sei kana uri mucia ukangowe involved in corruption wabatwa kana uri kufbi CIA inokushanda ukangoita any corruption wabatwa saka uri kuona kuzimbabwe tinongoine CIO chete which does not work it works for a political party when Mugabe was removed all the CIOs who were close to Mugabe were chucked away vamwe vakatofa musi wekuu vazhinji vakafa saka we don't want an intelligence agents inoshandira a political party ngaiite intelligence dzayo but they should not interfere neintelligence dzenyika because intelligence dzenyika ndozinotaura kuti nyika isaora tisanwa sewage tisashaya road dzekufamba tisashaya magetsi tikaona tishaya magetsi vakomana veintelligence vanopinda kunoinvestigate where are we getting it wrong why tisina magetsi munyika muno kana ari minister ari concerned those guys vanotata minister minister unotatwa kana ari president ane corruption zvoti kushaya magetsi munyika they recommend kuti president ungaabviswe kana ngaasungwe because of this and that and that saka if we had an intelligence agency in our country ingadai kutaura kwatiri kuita so tisina maproblems esati now but the problem is we have got an intelligence agency which is a wing of a ruling party so we don't want those wings of a ruling party when president Chamisa comes to power as a ruling party CCC we don't expect to see the intelligence of a country working for CCC. We expect to see them working for the intelligence of the nation, safeguarding the country. Unoziya ukasvika panhundu yemago ndedhi marumirwo andova nemago hapana kuti mago ripi hapana kuti mago api asimuka ipapo chero mago rasimuka ipapo rokung'anan'ura chero rokuruma bhozi vari kuprotekta nhundu Zimbabwe inofanira kuita nhundu yemago inofanira kuve a precious property to every Zimbabwean where the intelligence will guard it jealously pakangoda kungopinda any muvengi anorumwa nemago like hell. Surround Zimbabwe nemago bhozi igwari rumeka hwanhu nyuchi ikakuruma inobva yafaka kana mamusikazive nyuchi ikangokuruma chete inobva yafa ipapo ichingobhururuka kubva payakuruma yaburisa kambunyu kacho kaika yatoenda yakunofa haichararami but igo manje rumeka hwanhu ringe chikatendera dhedhi rikakuti n'a rodzoka roti n'a futa roenda rokuti n'a ende kana wangotanga kurumwa nehwani unenge wakunhuhwira unye wemago anokupedza ese saka nyika inoda kusaraundwa nemago asinei nechekuita nepolitics dzenyika dzekuti ruling party yazoita sei mapolitical parties rova nainside don't interfere with intelligence of a country ndosaka uchiona nhasi vana Biden vanorovana nanani vachitana sei vachiita pamatv vachiita madebates but they don't interfere with intelligence of a country ndosaka uchiona vana America vachinzi vane intelligence akasimba vana Britain vachinzi vane intelligence akasimba vese vana Boris vana Sunaka they've got no powers of interfering with intelligence. Intelligence is above them andimona saka we need to see such systems so with that in mind with that background in mind on the 27th of February this year tiri kunzwa kunzi tane tiri kunzwa kunzi masoja masoja ari kupinda mugwagwa kuda kudemonstrate saka kudemonstrate kwavari kuita masoja vari kuchema chavari kuchema chete masoja eZimbabwe vari kuchema salary vari kuchema salary musoja anotungamirira nyika the least a private least junior musoja least junior I expect least junior to take home about $2,000 considering the state of our economy munyika medu dai zvinhu zvakanaka a month we expect him kuti anogona kutora kuma $2,800-$3,000 US dollars a month musoja a private this is what exactly Zimbabwe has got about 30,000 active soldiers 30,000 chete and if you look at 30,000 soldiers if you pay them 3,000 each every month it's not much for people vanoswera vakabata pfuti defending a country. So we I personally expect a Zimbabwe soldier to earn about 2,000 at this with this economy atinayo yekuti nyika yekunzi haina mari iri bankrupt I expect a soldier to take home about £2,000 $2,000 because a minister akaita Samthuli Ncube is taking home almost 27,000 a month. Why can't we pay a soldier a living wage? Tikapam soldier 2,000, least junior, least private. Apinda basa nasi. Achitanga unzuri private yo army. Anifana kupinda achiwana $2,000. Ndo kutichotaura kuti tane masoja. Yekuti kana nyika tikanzi ta invadedwa nema rebels, ta invadedwa nanani. Because don't forget guys, kuti patakaenda ku DRC isusu. Tairusana nevarwandizi tairusana nevanhu vekuuganda those people are not happy because we thwarted them from taking a revenge against Laurent Kabila to the extent that they were serious they went to shoot and kill Kabila saka those people they want to initiate what we call dominance in SADC. They want even to come to Zimbabwe to fight the Zimbabwe government and to topple the Zimbabwe government. That is possible. I want you to keep this video. Last time I showed you last time. I don't think when I showed you last time good masoja e DRC warukuru wasei. Let me show you again. Good morning. Like what I was saying last time. Pano mwakazo ndiri shepa ndisendere. Urikuona aya masoja akafara. Aya, makongolese aya. Aya makongo akuruona M23. Izo ipfuti dzao dzakakepshwa izo ne M23 rebels. Urikuzona. Izi ava zvitunha izvi. Masoja eku DRC ya makongolese dzasabandero. Makongolese aya. These are all Congolese soldiers. So some of them are gruesome pictures. These are Congolese soldiers. You wonder which are Congo. Recently, I think two, 3 weeks ago. But I receive my message here, dear Asia. Could you know what I pack guys? What grow my M23? So M23 is the same, those are the same rebels we went to fight against. They are not help about Zimbabweans. They are willing to come and fight in your country. So, I want to fight militarily against Zimbabwe government. By now, I should have initiated it. General Shepherd, Vapinda Varoa Muzu, Vapinda Varoa Manikaland, that Otora Manikaland, Mash West in the Torre. By now, you are going to write, guys, there are so many cases, Kupinda Marar, Kunditore Arar. And Dainda Ida, quit a rebel leader. I could have become a rebel leader, And it all. But it's because we are not warmongers. Zimbabweans are not warmongers. Zimbabweans are peace-loving people. Although we are at the receiving end of a rogue political party, a banditry political party known as ZANU-PF, we are at the receiving end. Tinorohwa ati dzorere. We are killed ati dzorere. And in mono, ZANU-PF now, yashika pakunyara, yangotarisa chete. Vanhu vachikorohwa, vanhu vachirohwa, vanhu vachiurawa, vanhu vasingadzoseri, unorova munhu asingadzoseri. Tiri kurohwa tisingadzoseri. Tiri kuurawa everyday nevanhu vezanu, tisingadzoseri. Asarambonzwa kuti munhu weTripusi arova munhu wezanu kana munhu weTripusi auraya munhu wezanu. Yudha madi, Tripusi all the way, register to vote Fox. Thanks Mkoma Lento. This is what I'm talking about. That we are a peace-loving people. Zimbabweans tineka hospitality kedu tega. Although we have got a rogue government, we have got a banditry party that is presiding over our welfare as a nation. We are in trouble with the Zimbabwe government, with the ZANU-PF. This is a banditry party. These are bandits, people who are killing innocent people without even those people fighting back. We are not fighting back. We have been killed time and again. Since 2000, we have been on the receiving end. Today, ZANU-PF has killed so and so. There is a list now of over 3,000, 4,000 people who were murdered by ZANU-PF. But we have not even fought them back, not even once. The audio you played earlier is relevant. Thank you so much, David. So what I'm saying is, we have been at the receiving end of a banditry party known as ZANU-PF. We have been attacked. We have been killed. Relatives and friends were murdered by these bandits. But we never fought them, not even a day. Our opposition leader, Morgan Tsvangirai, told us never to retaliate. Guys, don't retaliate. These people are provoking a situation to create chaos in a country and call for state of emergency. It will be difficult for us to campaign or move from one place to another because the whole country will be under the military regime. Then we listened to Mdara Tsvangirai. Every day, we spend days, weeks, months at the graveyard, burying innocent people murdered by ZANU-PF. That trend did not stop from 2000. It became worse in 2002, worse from bad in 2000 to worse in 2002 to worse in 2008. And when they saw that Zimbabweans are not willing to fight back, they are now using it as bullying us, using it as a method to refuse us to campaign. But they say, you cannot gather. They are doing anything that they want with us because we cannot walk from one place to another and campaign. They've banned us. They've banned all our rallies. We can't campaign anymore. Triple C is a political party that is officially banned in Zimbabwe. The police deny us all the rallies. We have applied probably 1,500 rallies which were denied by the police. If you ask them, it's a very silly reason. Probably they don't have manpower. So we can't hold a rally because police does not have a manpower. You understand? So we are officially banned. If we are allowed by police to do a rally, ZANU-PF bandits will attack us, will kill people with machetes at our rally. A peaceful rally. They will just invade and start macheting people for no provocation, for no apparent reason. This is why I am saying here that ZANU-PF, you are just a lucky party. You are taking advantage of our hospitality as Zimbabweans. If I tell you, if I wanted, I'm being honest here, ladies and gentlemen. I am being honest here. If I wanted to be a rebel leader, by now Zimbabwe will be upside down. I am telling you. If I wanted to be a rebel leader, Zimbabwe will be upside down by now. Because I had a lot of people who approached me. Not Zimbabweans, outside Zimbabwe, some people in Mozambique, some people in Rwanda, some people in DRC, who have approached me for years to say, Shepherd, we know you are a brave man, and you can lead an army to Zimbabwe, and you can be president of that country if you want. But because I'm a peace-loving person, I always tell them that I had a president who, an opposition president, who used to tell me that if you fight militarily and take over government, that country will never realize peace. What we need is to follow a democratic rule where people will go register to vote, allow those people to go and cast their votes, and let those people vote. Whoever wins must run the country. If we do our things that way, Zimbabwe will ever be a peaceful country. Without violence, without firing any bullet, without bombs bombing places in Zimbabwe. But with only a pen, put your X on a part of your choice. Whoever wins, we count the votes. Whoever wins becomes the president of a country. This is what I believe. This is what Morgan Tsvangirai believed. This is what Nelson Chamisa believed. But this is not what Mnangagwa believed. This is not what ZANU-PF believed. ZANU-PF believes in provoking you to turn tables upside down in our country, to create chaos in our country. But Zimbabweans, we have resisted that. All the provocation that have been done by ZANU-PF, we have been patient, we have been quiet, we have been calm. We just looked when they butchered us. We never retaliated, not even a day. I've never heard of any opposition member who goes out there and burns someone's house. I've never heard about it. I've never heard of any opposition member abducting and torturing any ruling party member. I've never heard about it for the last 23 years. But count how many people were killed by ZANU-PF. How many opposition members were murdered by ZANU-PF. The list is there for you to see. That we have got human rights people in our country who compiled all this death. The manner of death. The place of death. The date of death. The time of death. They compiled everything. It's in black and white for everyone, everywhere in the world to see. Some people are wondering, but why Zimbabweans are so quiet? ZANU-PF, yes, is a violent party. They are on camera saying, Tokumamisai, Masisi is a dream party. They are on camera, on video saying, Chamisa must be killed. These are ZANU-PF people. Unawashi Tokumamisai wakumana, Tiri Antitrima, Antitrima Chima, Ma ambassadors ehondo. Violence is no gone. Chakumamisai wakumana. They are on video saying that. They are on video saying, even if we lose election, we can still rule the country because we've got the military. They are on record saying that. The problem is ZANU-PF, they forget that we are in a digital era, a time where every Zimbabwean now is a journalist. You have got a phone in your pocket, a computer in your pocket. You can record a video. You can throw that video right now on internet, and everybody will see it everywhere in the world. Zvasiyana nakare, kwamaingonzwa kuti takangonzwa kuti kwakapondwa munhu, atinonzwa kuti akaitwa sei. Enozvikana vakaabdukta munhu, vanotobatwa, they are captured, vachiabdukta vanhu. A very good example is that boy ainzi Mucheiwa, akaabdukta chubasikati machena, vakabatwa nemacameras, ma building cameras, andirikuona. Vakabatwa nenhamba dzemotokari nechidza vaiabdukta vanhu. Zvinonyadzisa. Zvinonyadzisa. Ndosaka ndiri kutaura kuti Zimbabwe, you are a lucky country. You are a lucky country. I don't think this will happen in Mozambique. I don't think this will happen in South Africa or Zambia. I don't think this will happen in Malawi, I'm telling you. You are just a lucky country. You've got people, vaneka dignity kavo, vane hunhu. I think Zimbabweans, we are unique in the world. We are of a certain kind in this world. We don't come from this planet, I don't think so. Because you can't do that in Uganda. You can't do that in Malawi, in Somalia, you can't do that. Ingadai kutaura kwandirikuita pfuti dzichirira muZimbabwe. That country upside down. Hondo yakatanga kudhara. Kubva pa 2000, pa 2008 was supposed to trigger a war in our country. A civil war. By now, it's a terror to connect in ZANU-PF. 2008 violence, the banditry that we witnessed in 2008 could have triggered a civil war in our country. But Zimbabweans resisted that. In 2008, I am telling you, in 2008, I almost became a rebel leader. I want to be honest with you guys. In 2008, I almost became a rebel leader. Kutaura kwandirikuita ingadai Zimbabwe, ndiri muZimbabwe, futi dzichiitwa hondo ichirohwa. Otherwise, takatotora nyika yakudhara. Dhara. Zimbabwe kadai takaitora kudhara takutoitonga. Kadai muchitaura kuti nyika yekutongwa naGeneral Shepherd. I said, Chengwanda, how are you? I am telling you guys, by now, when I left Zimbabwe, I had no intention of coming to England, to the UK. I had no intention of coming to this country. My intention was to go and source my training grounds and everything. Because Maria Changa Iripos, futi zacho zanga ziripo, zekungozi futi ziripo shepard, abanache kuchika, nyera amuzi peze ziripo, tungoda wanu chete wanuwe wa train, toku train na iwa fana. Uruona, 2008, nane nakato pinda mu Rwanda, nakato train at a ribo leader, nakato peze, nitorene masoja angu, nishivoku, nishidiploy, nishikana, nishidiploy, nishimami sana shakaipa mzimbabu. But you find good. I resisted guys. I don't think Zimbabwe needs war. No. It needs a working electoral system. We expect the United Nations to run the we expect UN supervised elections. I told Wakumana wa idagundi kuikundipa zombo. What we don't want is to see ZANU-PF government in that country. Ndo seka hangu tukawana mazimbabwezi wa chitawara ni marwandizi kuteshweshua. Rwanda is not yep about Zimbabwe. Uganda is not yep about Zimbabwe. Because when we went there to fight them, we repelled them. And the M23 are very strong rebels who are sponsored by real governments. Most of them are my rebels. Atori my soldiers, my regular soldiers. Enyika, ana Uganda, ana Rwanda. Uruona. Varuru tasagudi, tunufana kutorowa kabila. Boza ana kufufila. Kataka taka wirira. Zogut, by then, I had a rebel leader. I could have been a rebel leader if I wanted. No, this is not the nature of Zimbabweans. Zimbabweans, naturally, they hate war. They don't like war. We have seen a traumatic war during the 70s. We saw that. We don't want a repeat of that in our country. Our country needs peace. We need a UN-supervised election similar to the one that was done in 1980. Because since 1980, we were handed over reins to conduct our own elections. Imagine with the president of Zimbabwe, he is a player in an election. He is also, besides being a player in an election, Chengwanda, thank you so much. Besides being a player in the election, because he is going to be voted, he is also running the ZEC. I know what elimination report and I say in here. Saka ndiye anodetermine. Even in Musuwe kuti kuchaitwa my elections. Ndiye acha announce what my elections anoitwa rini. Saka apanenge pasina a free and fair election attribute. After that, ndiye anorana. Ano appoint Commissioner General of Police. And that same Commissioner General of Police anoenda through vetting ye security. Kuzikana kunzi. Ano kona ere kubvuma zvatinoda. Ndo saka muna Gordon Matanga ari ndiye ari kunyora matsamba ekubhana matripus kuti aite marale. So we are constricted. We are not allowed to campaign. We can't move from one place to another in our country. Mukangoungana chete pano masungwa. Kungoungana apo masungwa. And you understand what I mean. Saka there is no fair environment for any election in our country. Although we are ready, both people are ready to vote ZANU-PF out. But with difficulties that we are facing, we can't campaign. I think I'm going to vote out of the programs. Zimbabwe, you are a very lucky country. You are a very lucky country. Consider yourself lucky with this hospitality of people of Zimbabwe, people who are in Zimbabwe. Zimbabweans, they've got this type of hospitality that no any other country, you can find it in no any other country. We were under the British government. We were under the British rule. And we probably adopted a British style of government, or of behavior. Because the British are peace-loving people. You come to England, you can tell what I'm telling you. This country loves peace. You will never see people in the UK fighting because of politics. There could be one or two incidents, but not incidents of political violence as you find in Zimbabwe. You go to Northern Ireland. This is where I heard Gwaine Maribios, I heard food, this and that. The vines, the era, and so forth. But since I came to this country, I've never heard about them. You understand? I recently read an article from Zimbabwe that one of the most wanted men was the inhabitant in Zimbabwe, harbored in Zimbabwe. But what I'm saying is Zimbabwe must count itself as one of the luckiest countries in the world. Otherwise, there could be war in our country. If I had agreed to what these guys say to me, to say, vakatondi chaga wakomana, huh? Taona this, taona pa BBC News, taona pa chi, where is this guy? I don't know who referred them to where I was hiding. The next thing I heard was a phone call. Is this Shepherd Judah? Yes. We can. The first thing was, we can grant you asylum in our country. I said, you want to grant me asylum where? In Rwanda. Okay, fine. Then what? Then we've got Pane Urongwa. If you agree, Shepherd, you can be president of Zimbabwe. Do you know that you've got potential to become president of Zimbabwe? Nigada how? There are quite a lot of ways we can assist you to become president of that country. So, violent. If I was a violent man, I could have agreed on that. But I said, no, ladies and gentlemen, what I need at the moment is peace. I've lost a father, I've lost friends, I've lost relatives. So what I want is somewhere where I can sit down, probably receive counseling, stop crying. Because the state I am in, if I agree, then I can come take the weapons and go and fight in Zimbabwe. But I don't want. You fought many battles, Mdara, God bless. Thank you so much. You see, so if I had agreed, Zimbabwe would be in a war today. And I'm wrong. So that does not necessarily mean I'm the only one approached. There could be a lot of people approached. Some could have agreed to this. And as we go on, Zimbabwe is not going to win. But we don't want war in our country. We want peace. We are a peace-loving people. Naturally, we are a peace-loving people. Those are what you want to Zimbabwe. Atite zvinoita ma South Africans, zvechibhabhariki, zvinotora munhu kusatai muro, light that person, pour fuel, petrol that person, and bang, a human being alive. We don't do that in our country. I was surprised to see greetings from Pretoria, Zviri Semguma, Chris. I was surprised to see that in Zimbabwe, under ZANU-PF government, someone can be abducted and that person disappears. Itai Dzamara has disappeared with no clue of where they put him. By now, I think the High Court should just declare him dead and close the chapter until probably after we gain independence. Yeah. Dambuzo is violent. He's a violent man. How can you go around with the 1,000 people guarding you with weapons? One day is one day. These guys are underpaid. One day is one day. Though they will turn that gun to him. Believe me. I'm saying keep this video so that when it happens, you tell me, Shepherd, I'm 18 February. Kuti Dambuzo akaramba achita zvaari kuita izvi, vanhu will turn these guns to him. he will be blown off. Anzi kana chamisa otonga toda kukuita mukuru wemajeri mudaraida toda kudzoserai kubasa kwenyu. Okay, ngoma crazy ndazvinzwa, but the problem yapo manje position yacho haidona vakaenda kuchikoro kayai. I don't know that this is a man to be commissioner general of prison or police. I don't think Zoda Mnagana was called. Both commissioner general of police and Gordon Matanga and Zanagana grade savior. So I don't think could Zoda Ameno. If president feels like that, then I cannot say no to the president. What I need to do is. Bozi mkuru wangu zve murume wetabva kuru wakomana unoziva kuti pane pamwe pokuti kana ndikafunga chamisa soka ndiri kumuona akapfeka chimwe chijini chake kudhara akuma 1999 ari iye president weyouth kumdc murume wendafamba ndabva naye kure vakomana haasi munhu wekuti I can just discard like tissue andiona munhu wekuti I can defend with my blood. I don't know visage of Muro. Nagarosha Missika would captain Chovara Bog Amari captain Agapua one up to be a major. Ugadenda Amand of Wunza. Ha! Honestly, my prison officers, Magashaya, Magad Jerry, Vanos Vabasa, who you are going to promote to be a commissioner general. Mugadorajo of Vu. No sequa. Masoja, saka masoja wakaona prison vanenge vachiti is a dumping site yevanhu vasingagone kunyora. Taive neumwe mudhara mainzi Mafuta anga ari prison police akasagone kana kunyora angakuta zvezvimudhudhudhu tikada musagwara man anhai mudhara idha saka hanzi Skala vanoda kuti abude rini nhai mudhara what they are doing, they are using Skala kuti imimi vanhu muputike. Zanu PF iri kuda kuti vanhu muve violent. Ndosakaona president chamisa wakati remain calm. Even vaSkala chavanzi vakasenda message wakati no guys, remain calm. I've been in this prison for too long. Saka hapasina chekutya. Imimi kwapanza apa remain calm. Mwari vachaita sekuda kwavo. Hanzi Skala, hanzi mudhara Skala wakadaro. Andiona. Havasi kuda kuti muite noise. Mudhara Skala hanzi vakata kuti no, zvese zvemaprotest chichi leave it. Handiriona nyadzisai muvengi. Saka Zanu PF now yapererwa. Ndosaurona vakuti kana ukaenda kucourt hanzi magistrate arwara, prosecutor ane manyoka, zvaita sei, so that they frustrate you guys. You go into the streets, start breaking things over. Once you see vanhu ava the violent part. Saka na president, hanzi na vice chairman wa Job Skala, calm down. Musawane chamunoita, let me fight them in courts. Because apana nyaya. And it mon. Chatango chikira pa nomination court, because he has to be nominated. Kunyangu ari prison, anofana contest ari mjeri mu. He must contest ari prison. Saka warupa ground, itoita ibasa. To nominate Arimo, I know a candidate Arim Jerimo. Odo wina Arimo foot in Jerimach. And it mon. Saga, let's remain calm. We are I am Dara Yuda, but Kanavaguti, but at the era my elections at the Buddy, Mustreet in Dara Yuda, Tatambura. Yeah, no, those are two to Chris. There is a GoFundMe which requires you guys to contribute. Because what we want to do, unoziva zvinoitwa maelections. Maelections aya vanhu vanoenda kunovhota. Maresults anoverengwa ipapo, onyorwa papepa, ostikwa panze. Saka vanhu chiregai kubva ipapo, musachinjirwa maresults. Rambai maresults enyu makachengeta amapiwa iwayo. This is how people are saying we need to defend our vote. Pa polling station yega yega. Maresults papedza kuverengwa mabata maresults enyu musabva hapo kusvika final result yaita sei yaanaunzwa ande musabva ipapo bosi mukona zvoita vanhu vaingoti pakangonzi panapaita vanhu vapedza vanhu votongorova pasi maresults aisarawo chinjwa poda Waizwa mari zvavo zvasiriyo zanu PF yotoriga. Because apana within 30 minutes by vote on 300,000 Mashonaland and Central. Saka those areas like Mash Central, Mash East, Zeso na Kwekwego na Midlands, we need kuisama election agents ikoko and we defend our vote. Those who tell one around, chet, let's defend our vote. If we defend our vote, unengo magabata result ni magabata, apana nuri chinja. Moro zari result labida apana ndirakati. And we tally them to win an election. Those are going to Zanu PF kuchika zvakaipa. They are so scared. They don't know what Chamisa is planning. And it was. What was that? Murumu waji is a strategist. Pa waifu wata peza, tatura pati tapa Munzura. Munzura yoko over. Taka bataka nda joka. Saka, what is there now, ladies and gentlemen, is to make sure we've registered. Munwese, are you within your circle? Is registered to vote. As Mdara Ida Tawakuda, Zema Rebels is a very idiot. The problem at Nayo Chris is we are a peace loving people. Is there Wondo, is guys, Zimbabwe was real. Especially Isus Takaona Wondo, Ian Smith. That war was traumatic, was a nasty war. And we don't want a repeat of that war. So the best thing is we vote peacefully. When Zanu PF goes, yo vazvakanaka. Asi kana Zanu PF taidya, ichida hondo, let them go to the bush, then we'll deal with them there. Because tine ma youth akashatiyo. Tine youth in Zimbabwe, which is a potential bomb, which can explode anytime. Our youth is a potential bomb, can explode any minute. Saka kana Zanu ikafunga kuti yaba election kana tairova election yakuda kuita zvehondo, let them go into the bush. We will deal them with them ruthlessly. To recruit our fana vese vamuri kuona varushaya mabasa, we recruit and train them. Then we say, guys, let's go defend our vote, let's go defend our country. Kana tato wina chete, we can do anything. Kana Zanu PF yatinda hondo nesu, topinda navo musango macho. KuZambia ndozvada havaende, kuMozambique havaende, Botswana havaende, kuSouth Africa wese hakuna. Saka vamhendo vanorwa hondo yacho vakamira papi. Vakaenda kuMuzarabantu, we wipe them. Handikunyeperi. Bhozi, kana tajako vangokoda zvehondo, isu tinongotenga ndege dzekuvarova chete. Totenga zvikopoko, kwete zvimaaluti 3, totenga zvikopoko zvehondo chaizvo. Tutumamisana nao. Saka ayo kurambira avarambire, because if we defend our vote avarambire. Chris, mark my words, let's defend our vote avarambire vanorwa pasi. So that is something that we want. We are a peaceful loving nation, and let's continue to be calm at the height of chaos. President Chamisa today is not allowed to travel anywhere to campaign. We are not allowed to campaign in Zimbabwe. But they are making an error now. That is an error. Because they are not gauging our strength. By not allowing us to gather, they can't gauge our strength. It's just we have gained more ground than Zanu PF. And we are ready for any election today. They can't gather. They can't judge our strength. Vanhu vanopfosa vachitakura nemabhazi vachiunganidza vachiti Zanu yakasimba, havasi vanhu vavo. 90% of those people don't belong to Zanu PF. Takavataura kuti kana mukanzi mat-shirts pfekai, kana mukanzi kumusangano endai, mukanzi vamberi nezanu simudzai zvibhagira stere. But musi wokunovhota ndichivaratidzai kuti hatichada kuramba tichifoserwa kuenda kuzvinhu zvisina basa tichisiya kurima. Andimona, vote them out of power. Zanu PF is gonna be shocked. And Saka, people were asking me if the army is going to demonstrate Musoa 27 as tweeted. You don't rule that one out. And a strong chiguba aripo anamari mkazi uya akaoma. Haana zvaanoita kana ta defender voted. Anenge atori ready kutiza chete. Vanachigumba they will run away. But we will get back, go into those servers, we will examine everything. Because if we win this election, the 28th election will be forensically, we will be audited forensically. We want qualified forensic scientists look into ZEC server 2018 election results. Then we want to see if there is any manipulation of that election. That means Chigumba is a criminal. She needs to be incarcerated. So quite a lot of things. What she can only save herself is to flee Zimbabwe. But if she leave Zimbabwe and go elsewhere, when after forensic auditing of 2018 results, if we see any manipulation, we can still apply to any country she goes to. Munu is a criminal. We want him for this and that and that. And she will be repatriated. We send her to prison. Very simple. And you know, that is not retribution, but we want justice done. Usapara mosha nasi, uchiti dine, ndakachengetwa nezano. Mangwana zano inenge sipo isina kuchengeta, mosha dzako dzinodzoka. July this year, ndo patrukisa patruke na unovota. Kuda ndoda kuisa ex yangu pana president chamisa. Thank you so much Mkoma Chris. I think in July, ndo parukuya pachaenda wanu unovota. Saka what we are saying is, wanachi gumba, shaka nakira maseva, ndeze kuti, even if you delete information, that information, we can still recover deleted information forensically. The only way you can do probably is to take chiseva chacho kunochikanda mvura chisawanike. But as long as chiseva chacho chiripo, we can retrieve any information we want from that server. Raw data. But if I delete anything here, you can go delete up face up. But behind it, kune makechi zakawanda anogara that information. Yekuti we can retrieve it with the software. Any information can be retrieved. Saka maseva as long as aripo, ZANU-PF is now kanda mgungwa. We can still do forensic auditing. Yema election esa akaitwa kuti 2018 election chichakaitika. We can see the. You can retrieve original data ichipinda. Kuti original data yakafamba from here ikasvika apa, ikabva apa ikaenda apa, yakasvika apa apa yakazochinjwa apa muso wakati nguva dzakati zvese zvinowanika izvozvo. So don't worry guys, it's a matter of time. Let's go vote in our millions. Let's vote ZANU PF out. Let's have forensic auditing of the 28 election results. Kana vanachigumba vakaita zvigure zvavo, round them up or take them to court, put them in prison. Because ukaona mhosva dzakadaro dzotora kana ma 15 years, 30 years mujeri. Unorohwa 30 years mujeri. Because every manipulation yawakaita anenge ari ma 5 years mujeri. Kana wakaita 10 times manipulation une 50 years mujeri haubudi. Saka vanozviziva paya kuti they are potential bandits. Ma prisoners aya in waiting. Saka muri kuona tikutaura kuti they have to be very careful. Ukaona wapuwa basa rero, ukaona rusunga richikupinza pakuti manipulator ma results, vataura kuti no, regai ndidzoke ndingoita judge zvangu. So let's register to vote in numbers and vote for change. Then protect our vote. Zvatopera tatopedza. Saka not guys, this is almost 2 o'clock. Good night. Gaindo norara. 2 a.m.